nurse in the labor and delivery department. Dr. McAuliffe, a staff obstetrician, has delivered a term male newborn. The infant's muscle tone is good, but the newborn is not breathing or crying. 1. The initial interventions you should perform include all of the following except A. Begin to warm the infant. B. Clear his secretions. C. Clamp the umbilical cord. D. Position the newborn to open the airway. Correct answer, C. Clamp the umbilical cord. At this point, clamping the umbilical cord is not essential. The team should dry and warm the infant, position him to open his airway, and clear secretions from the infant's mouth and nose. The infant continues with apnea. 2. Your next intervention should be A. Assess heart rate. B. Prepare to intubate. C. Begin CPR. D. Apply a pulse oximeter. Correct answer, A. Assess heart rate. The infant's heart rate is 80 beats per minute. 3. Your next interventions should include all of the following except A. Begin assisting ventilations with a PPV device. B. Apply a pulse oximeter. C. Consider a cardiac monitor. D. Insert an ET tube. Correct answer, D. Insert an ET tube. The clinician should remember that most cardiac issues in the neonatal population are a result of respiratory distress. Intubation should be performed if PPV therapy fails to increase the heart rate or if prolonged ventilation is required. Therefore, you can often reverse respiratory distress by ventilation. It is important to know the heart rate of the infant to determine if ventilations are improving the infant's status. A cardiac monitor will help you easily see the cardiac results of your respiratory interventions. At the next assessment, you note that the heart rate is still 84 beats per minute. You verify that the child's chest is rising with each ventilation. 4. The next intervention you should choose is A. Begin CPR. B. Begin ventilations. C. Apply a laryngeal mask. D. Place the infant with skin-to-skin contact with the mother. Correct answer, C. Apply a laryngeal mask. A laryngeal mask airway, LMA, may be considered as an advanced airway alternative to intubation in the neonates with gestation greater than 34 weeks. Until the baby is breathing, it is not appropriate to place him with his mother. If the respiratory effort had been normal, the team should consider placing the infant in skin-to-skin contact with the mother. After applying the laryngeal mask, you notice this rhythm on the monitor. Five, you identify this rhythm as A, sinus rhythm, B, sinus bradycardia, C, first degree heart block, D, third degree heart block. Correct answer, B, sinus bradycardia. This rhythm has the same characteristics as sinus rhythm, except that the rate is slower than 60 beats per minute. 6. A normal heart rate for a newborn baby is A, 60 beats per minute, B, 72 beats per minute, C, 80 beats per minute, D, at least 100 beats per minute. Correct answer, D, at least 100 beats per minute. The infant's heart rate remains below 60 beats per minute and is developing some central cyanosis. 7. At this point, you should A. Prepare for intubation, B. insert an umbilical catheter, C, begin chest compressions, D, both A and C. Correct answer, D, both A and C. While preparing to intubate, begin chest compressions as the heart rate has dropped below 60. 8. As a team prepares for intubation, other team members should do all of the following except A. Prepare for insertion of umbilical venous catheter, B. Increase oxygen concentration to 28%, C. Begin chest compressions, D. Continue PPV. Correct answer, B. Increase oxygen concentration to 28%. Instead, the team should increase the oxygen concentration to 100%, prepare for possible insertion of an umbilical venous catheter, continue chest compressions until the infant's heart rate is above 60 beats per minute, and continue PPV. After intubation and continued PPV with 100% oxygen, you notice that the infant's heart rate is 120 beats per minute. You prepare to transfer the infant to the neonatal ICU.